Yes, hello, good evening. It's nice
Evening.
to see you again. How are you today?
I'm fine.
Okay, definitely. I can see that you're really fine today. Okay, and what did you do for today?
Work is cool.
Okay, and aside from that, so the whole day you just went to school, you didn't go anywhere. Yes. Okay. So, yeah, how about the weather for today? Is it still rainy? Oh, sunny. Sunny now. Yeah, because yesterday you said it's rainy, right? Okay, well, today we're going to continue to study your book. I hope you still remember what we had last time. Okay, please wait, I'll share it with you. All right, there you go. Can you see your book?
Yes.
All right. Okay, so yesterday we had talked about sentences about the food will never be the same again. Okay, so yeah, this time let's go for grammar focus. Can you please read the sentences?
If you put honey in your teeth, it becomes sweet. If you leave sugar in the sun, it becomes very soft. If you put in water or freezer, it turns to ice.
Correct. Okay, so as you can see, everything that is highlighted are some are verbs. Yes. So, yeah, as you can see on the first sentence, what is the verb there?
Becomes.
Correct. Okay, so why do we use becomes instead of become? Okay, so I'll give you an explanation to that. It's because we're using the plural it, I mean, sorry, the pronoun it. Okay, so if a sentence or, in a sentence, right after the word it, okay, so the next verb would be into plural form. So it becomes, all right, what else? For example, it rains. Okay. So, yes, that's how it works. Okay. So, everything in the example before the sentence or the word it or after it is the plural verb. Okay, this one. Okay, so did you get that?
Okay.
Good job. All right, so now in this sentences that you are reading, they have actually two phrases. Okay, so first one is this, and then the second one is this one. Okay, as you can see, all of them has its meaning, right?
Okay.
Yes. Okay. So first sentence or first word of the sentence is if. Okay. So if you live, and if you put. Okay. So everything in that sentence has its meaning. Okay. Now, can you try to make your own sentence? You can write it down. Can you write it down here? Or you can try to write in the chat box.
Okay.
Okay, let me see. Oh, in summer it becomes fun. Oh, is summer your favorite season?
Yep.
Why do you think so?
Because I can play with my cousins.
You mean to say you can do a lot of activities on summertime?
Yes,
okay, I believe so. But if you're gonna apply that here in our country, I guess summer is the worst because it's really, really hot. Yes, okay. All right, anyways, that's a good sentence. Okay, now let's proceed to playing the food game with a partner. Imagine that you have pills of 6 different colors. So tell your partner what food you get. Okay, so we have an example here. Please read.
If you put butter in blue pill, you get potatoes with peanuts.
Okay, so yeah, it's an imagination game. So yeah, you can say it in this way. Okay, you can make your own sentence too with that one. Okay, so let me go first. If you, okay. If you put, ice, or if you put more water in a black pill, you get carrots and black beans. Okay. So yeah, this is generally an imagination of different colors. Yeah. Okay, so you can make it too. Can you try it?
Okay.
Yes. Okay, you can type it there too if you can. Okay. So if you put fresh water in the orange peel, you get fresh oranges and carrots. That's great. Okay. Yes, a very great example. Very good. Okay, so yes, everything that you have made for sentences is great. Okay, I like that. Now let's look at the pictures and where can you see these things. So we have knives and forks, lots of washing up, a birthday cake, pots with steam. Okay, so anyways, let's just look for it after we read the story. The story is about the birthday meal. Okay, so let's see. Can you please read?
The friends sat around the table. After 10 minutes, the greater cake was started. There were three bowls with something else in them. Harden soup with fish and pepper. The greater said, they tried to eat the soup with the soup, but it didn't work. The soup was hard. It just turns it into the air. They can eat it more easily. The greater, but they turn the soup out of both into the air. The soup got onto the table and put them in their hands. They have looked at orange bowls. The children tried to pick up the bowls with their feet, but they always throw it away. It's easier if you've got chopsticks. We are sent. So they eat the little bowls and the chopsticks. The soup is really good. PV said. They said, fishy, but very sweet. I did too. Alice agreed, but I'm still hungry.
Okay, let me read this part for you. Okay, please listen. Okay, the waiter came in with a second course. There were four big pots with lids on. When the waiter took the lids off, colored steam came out of them. Beef, carrots, broccoli, and crocodile, he said. You have to eat the steam fast or it will disappear. The children took their spoons and tried to eat the steam as quickly as possible. But they didn't get much. I can't believe that all we have to eat is soup and steam, said Alex. What's for dessert? The children asked. Wait and see, answered the waiter. Okay, next.
The kitchen door opened with a loud noise. The Phoebe, Alex, and Becky saw a huge spaceship sailing towards them. On it, there were lots and lots of burning candles. Happy birthday, shouted the waiter and the spaceship and in front of Phoebe.
Okay.
Blow out the candles. Alex said, please help me, answer Phoebe. That's too many. Together, they blew out the candles. Hooray! The spaceship is made of chocolate. And there's ice cream inside. Phoebe shouted. Alex touched him. I am the fool.
That's wonderful, Phoebe said. At that moment, the waiter came and gave them the bill. It's 60,000 gold stars altogether, he said.
What? We haven't got any gold stars, Patrick answered. I'm afraid that you have to work in the kitchen for a week. The children laughed sadly and walked to work in the kitchen. When they got to the door, a golden girl appeared around it. And that he just stood up and walked into it. They were coming in a flash.
All right. Yes. Thank you so much. And that ends with the story of the birthday meal. Okay. So where do you think they are in this story?
The waiter, Patrick, Alex, and Phoebe.
Yes. I mean, where are they? They are at?
A spaceship.
Yes, at space, correct. Since there's just a robot, okay, the waiter that they have encountered right there. Okay, so at first they were very happy, right? Mm-hmm. They have also, what have they eaten?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Mm-hmm. All right. They have also, yeah, eat the steamed, and yeah, because the waiter said that they have to eat the steam before it will disappear. Okay. And the dessert that they were eating was the big cake that's flying. Yes, with a lot of candle. All right. And what happened in the last part of the story? Why are they washing the dishes?
Because they are washing lots of dishes.
Mm-hmm. Aside from that, it's because the waiter is asking for the bill. Money. Yes. And how much is the bill?
$60,000.
Yes. But the children hasn't got any money for that or any gold stars. Mm-hmm. And suddenly they saw a golden glow appears in the room. And what they do is they run fast and walk into it and disappeared just very quickly. Okay, so now let's try to answer the first activity. Mm-hmm. So where can you see these things? Knives and forks.
Can you give me a stamp?
Yeah, for example, the first picture, second picture.
Okay.
Yeah, knives and fork.
Can you give me a pen so I can circle one?
Ah, okay. You cannot annotate or something?
Yes.
All right, please wait. Okay, can you try?
Okay.
All right, that.
That's the knife and fork.
Okay, correct. It's in the first picture. Okay, wait. All right. Okay, I'll go up. Okay, I'll clear it first. All right. And how about lots of washing up? Where can you see it? Correct. Okay. Yes, this one. Mm-hmm. Exactly. Yes, that's right. I get it. Okay, very good. Next will be a birthday cake.
Yeah.
There, correct. And what else? A pot with steam. Yes, okay, very well. So we have found everything that we're looking for. Okay, in the picture. All right, please wait. All right, okay, so now let's answer the questions. What was the first course? Like the first meal or menu?
Soup. And orange soup of fish and pepper.
Yes, correct. Okay, that's the first course. And next, how could they catch the orange balls? How could they catch the orange balls?
They use chopsticks.
They use chopsticks? Are they using chopsticks? Yes. So I guess the fork and knife isn't working, right? So they are using chopsticks. Okay. Next, what was the second course? How about the second course?
It's a four cans cooking pot lid on.
Yes, that's right. It's the four big pots with lids on. So we can see there the beef, carrots, broccoli, and the crocodile. Okay. And next, what did they have for dessert?
Yeah, birthday cake.
They have a birthday cake. And what money does the restaurant take? Exactly. And what did the waiter tell them to do? Yes, what did the waiter tell them to do? That?
Not me.
Yes, that they have to wash the dishes. Yes, since they cannot pay for the gold stars in the restaurant. Okay, all right, so yes, thank you for answering the questions. Now let's read and match the prices with the objects, okay? So it's like doing math. So if a three-course meal for three costs 60,000 gold stars, how much do you think these things cost at the edge of the universe? Okay, so that's a total of 60,000 gold stars. If the course, I mean, the three-course meal is 60,000. How about this one? How much is a can of Space Cola?
$1,000.
Okay, you think this is 1,000 gold stars?
Yes.
Okay. How about a trip to the 60 cinema?
100,000 gold stars.
100,000 gold stars. Yes. All right, that makes sense. And a jet booster bike.
$50,000 gold stars.
I'll put it down there. 50,000 gold stars. And a pet zonk.
$10,000
gold stars. Okay. Which one is cheaper and which one is expensive?
Because Space Cola is cheap and a trip for 60 cinema is expensive.
All right. Why do you think so?
Because Space Cola, I mean, We have one flower goes first, and after the 60th, it's not that because it's 100,000 gold stars.
Okay, so you think that among these four things right here, okay, so a trip to the 60 cinema is more expensive among all. Yes, actually, I would agree with you to that. Yes, because in Earth, right, in our planet, this is so expensive if you're going to watch a 60 cinema, right?
Okay.
Yes. So at the edge of the universe, it would be really more expensive. Yes. It really costs a lot of money. Okay. Anyways, yes, thank you for that. Now let's read the blog and match the pictures with the paragraphs. Okay. So let me read it first. It's the chocolateblog.com. Oh, by the way, do you have a blog?
No.
I know. Okay. So yeah, for all things sweet and chocolatey. Okay. So I'm going to read this paragraph first one. I'm crazy about chocolate. So it's no surprise that my favorite book is Charlie and the Chocolate Factory by the wonderful Roald Dahl. Forget Charlie Bucket. The real hero of the book is Willy Wonka, inventor of the most amazing sweets in the world. Here are just a few of his delicious creations. First,
chewing gum is a completely cursed meal. Tomato soup, olive oil, rose, green, root beef, blueberry pie, or desert. I think I've used different curses too. Willy Wonka also invented a chewing gum that never looked its way. Very useful.
Okay, number two.
Hot ice cream for a cold day. What a great idea. Now I can eat ice cream every day. He also invented an ice cream that never melts. Very useful.
Okay, three.
Wallpapers that you can eat. This wallpaper comes with pictures of bird outfit. Orange, gray, apples, bananas, more like a pictures you taste of food. But brilliant.
Yes. Okay. Alright, so let's stop in there. Yes. Anyways, we'll just continue everything in our next class since we're running out of time. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so well, thank you so much for your time and see you again. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.